Why not, man?
I'm coming for that number one spot.
All right.
Woo! Rappers swearing they own top.
But
I'm coming for that number one spot.
All right, man.
Scheme, scheme, plot, plot.
Say what?
I'm coming for that number one spot.
Woo!
Hey, keep it going, it won't stop.
What you doing, man?
I'm coming for that number one spot.
Yeah, relationships, man. How do y'all handle that?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I know how you handle yours because y'all dress the same.
My buddy.
Ain't nobody can get confused.
Wherever I go,
ain't nobody can get confused.
Right.
Yeah, every time I ever see y'all motherfuckers,
them
y'all be on some set. They got the same.
They not playing. Yeah.
The key to keeping your girl in this industry is making her know that she the only one that matters, even though there's a whole bunch of other women around.
Mm-hmm.
Pulling up, long as she know that you repping her 100%, you can probably be doing whatever you want to do. But as
exactly.
long as she's number one, it don't matter. So just keep it like that, and you all
do the last part.
We dress alike.
Hold on, do last part. last part again.
No, you talking about you probably could be doing what you.
Yeah, that part right there.
That's the only part you're looking for.
Yeah. So how can get her to be cool with all that?
Like, you over here throwing stir in the pot. Stop it.
Nah, I'm not me. Personal.
Yeah.
I'm just saying.
Nokia.
Else.
Huh?
So
same question.
Look at me.
He said, huh?
Look at me.
He said,
how would you deal with your relationship?
Exactly.
Hold on. Chris.
Yeah, let me think about that.
I think bro kept it real because my girl knows I'm a keeper player. Or
oh,
anything.
You know what?
We saw you earlier today.
Like a player mindset, but he makes a good point. Let your girl know. Like,
he had a bottle. He walked around. That shit stayed on the same level the whole time.
Oh, yeah, you ain't getting that shit out to nobody. I was like,
yeah, he said
no,
shit.
That,
I heard him saying I wanted a sip, and you was like, yeah, there was some more shit over there.
You see the buzz talk.
Yeah, some over there. Get you a buzz ball. Right there. Lick them balls right there. Take them balls, the buzz balls.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Oh, man. Whenever they call it, oh, man, yeah. Why would you say that?
The buzz ball.
Get it out of
there. Nah, I totally agree with you, bro. You let your
you totally agree with everybody when you call. Go ahead.
Yeah.
You was right. I was wrong.
Got it. Even if you're going to keep it player, just let the one who matters know.
Yeah.
Because in this industry, whatever we do, it's going to be like me in this room right now, your girl might trip. But if she knows, you got to let people be.
But if y'all dressed alike, then, you know.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Don't forget.
Yes, yes.
She looks so content. She has no worries.
She don't care.
She don't care.
She
don't care. Ain't nobody trying
to me.
Ain't nobody trying to
me. Nobody.
Oh, you see this?
Same velour sweatsuits, you know what I'm saying?
With the same energy too, I met y'all together.
You did.
In All-Star Weekend in February, and I was blind. And y'all niggas looked the same.
Y'all had different
colors?
They was coordinated.
Wow.
Together. They was on some like drill team type shit.
No, look, my girl, she's not really into like the high fashion kind of thing, and I am, you know what I'm saying? So I'll be using her as my canvas, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, let's go, let me try to make, you know, just make something. I'm trying to, you know.
If I wanted another bitch, just what I would want her to wear.
She don't be caring. She'd be like, man, can we throw on some Tim's?
You play Barbie dolls with your girl.
You know, dress up, whatever you want to call it, but in the, you know, I just wanted to compliment me, and she do.
That's
all the
right.
Time.
How, I don't know, how you feel about that? Don't know that. How you feel about that?
She want to throw some Tim's and some jeans and a t-shirt.
I think for me, I'm so New York,
because
I'm from here, so I'm so used to like throwing on my Tim's, pair of jeans, t-shirt, hoodie, or my leather, and I'm good. But you know, I'm a woman, I'm getting older, I got my man.
Okay.
So I gotta compliment my man.
That's
Hey, we better compliment, honey. Hey, remember that time I almost broke y'all up?
Uh-oh.
With Beyonce?
Which time, bro?
Oh no!
Every time you come around, it's some bullshit.
It's some bullshit. It's some bullshit. Some old Jack the Land shit.
Some bullshit. I try to plug her ears whenever we get around too.
Hey, wait, yo, they came over my house. She wasn't there.
No, she wasn't.
She was on FaceTime. But hey, Rod went over my house. We had a discussion about Beyonce and Michael Jackson, and the artistry.
No, Beyonce and Monica.
No,
Sierra.
It was
Sierra.
Oh,
that's from my woman over here. She's like, she said no, but that's
and they broke up.
No, I love that. They broke up over this shit.
We broke up for about 10 minutes.
I had them broke up for 10 minutes over this shit. Watch this shit.
I'm just saying, like, when I say something in public, you supposed to agree, whether you agree or not. You know what I'm saying? But she didn't do that this time, so we had a little problem. But it's alright.
You like, I know, I think Beyonce, 3LW.
You know what?
Because she says Sierra's better than Beyonce.
You know, I didn't say that. I said the artistry is different. I said I like both of myself, but I just
hey, we on TV, remember? Okay. Right. We dress alike.
Hey, artistry. What was the question? Give it to Nokia. Artistry and what?
Relationship,
baby.
Man, look. I wanted to come into the business with girl that was with me through everything that I went through to get into it. And her feeling was like she would rather me be able to experience everything that comes along with being in the business.
Take that down?
Yeah, no, this sure. Than to
this it.
Just, you know, have me come in a relationship and then something end up happening because I'm curious.
Is that love?
It was. I mean, in hindsight, it was, man, because, like, we still friends to this day.
Mm-hmm. To this day.
That's dope.
Yeah, like she co-wrote 96. Five Steps.
Oh, wow.
Like, she wrote most of it, actually.
Oh, wow.
You know what I'm saying? So, you know, like, once in it, you know, I think I've, like, learned just about all the lessons you could learn about being in this business. And, you know, at the end of the day, man, I think what it all comes down to is, like, you can't really love nobody until you fully love yourself.
That's true.
And, like, loving yourself has so many levels to it that, you know, it's not just the happy, and it's not just the eating the good food, and it's not just going to, it's so many things that, like, you really have to, like, you really gotta make sure that you check that, man.
Cheers to that, man. Like, loving yourself. Real talk. Cheers to loving yourself, man. Real talk.
Yeah.
Because you ain't going to get nowhere without that, bro.
Because, for real, like you're going to hurt people.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
If you ain't got mm-hmm. yourself. And it's not always just in, like, cheating. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're not able to be there for somebody because you don't have the information.
This is true.
You know,
consideration.
It's like so many things that, like, go that, you know, I wrote a million songs about. So, you know, it's not easy, man. Like, it's the hardest shit in the world. You know, it works when it works, and when it's fucked up, it is totally
it hurt, man.
And sometimes it's not even you that they want that to have to experience it. Sometimes the person that you with from that point can't take that, because that's what I went through. The person I was with cheated on me on live TV in front of everybody.
Oh, not her.
I'm talking about.
I know it wasn't
shit. Leading up. I'm saying the person that you come up that you want to be with. Sometimes they have a more effect on the person that you come up with than you. Like, you might be able to mentally take it when you get in this industry.
It's fantastic.
And be a, no.
Stop.
No. Everybody know. They seen the when people that
work. Did you not tell them Jim Tong?
Come on, don't back them up again.
Tong is what?
No, but sometimes you can have everything you need when you get in this industry. It's okay. Mentally, even to deal with a relationship with the woman that you've been with prior to. Mm-hmm. But it might be too much on her.
Yeah.
She might not be.
Yeah, might meet the wrong one.
You know what I'm saying? It might be worse on her than it is on you. And that's when I went through that. She couldn't withstand it. You know what I'm saying? It was too much for her. She got too famous, and I'm the one that's it. You know what I'm saying? But that's
too
how
famous
it
for the
yo, the illest thing, the woman ever told me, and this is when I totally just, that was like the last piece of probably was like, for real, sometimes it's not even about the fact that you did something. Sometimes you just get tired of people coming to you, acting like they know shit.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Put that in.
Yep, and they just can't take it. I just can't take it.
All right.
Whether you did it or not, I'm tired of hearing it. All
right. So what are the lines that you guys have, like, drawn for you, like, for this relationship? You know, like, you guys, she has her, what is it?
Hang-ups?
Yeah, like, basically, what are the things that you guys both was like, this is a line, we both will never cross it, and going forward in this relationship?
We both young, so we don't really know those lines yet, you know? Mm-hmm. Honestly, I'm going to just be honest with you. Relationships go through a lot of things, and especially when you're in this industry, you face a lot of things that the average person don't face, you know what I'm saying? So it's kind of hard to even it's kind of hard to even make those kind of.
You can't even do it. It's not even a realistic. Because you normally, when you're trying to make a relationship with somebody that's a civilian, civilian meaning you're not in a relationship, like inside the business and stuff. You can't, y'all ain't on the same page because y'all lives ain't different. Right. Your lives are different and you can't even like fathom the problems that each other have and whatnot.
Right.
And what they don't know the levels of what's dramatic to you, what's not dramatic to you.
She's a school teacher. I'm an entertainer. Like, you know what I'm saying? So it really, you couldn't be no different. You couldn't be no more opposite.
Odd couple.
You know what I'm saying? I'm smoking and drinking. She's doing paperwork and, you know, trying to get the smoke out of my face.
But you need somebody. You need somebody that don't do this shit.
I mean, but it's real talk. I'm up to 100 o'clock in the morning. She got to get up at 100 o'clock in the morning. We going, you know what I'm saying? So it's just, it's the love between the two people, man, have to be that. It have to be real. And that's where you figure out what it real is.
Yeah. Because you can't, like, look, I remember somebody telling me too, I was in love with some artists, was like, don't care, well, why you want to go out with a crazy artist like you? And I said, makes sense.
I said the same thing, bro.
But like, you need to balance, like, I was saying earlier, like, yo, 3 months, a year, 3 years, just out in the middle. And especially, like, if you're one of them artists, which I never fucking understood in my life. If I gotta be around you for months at a time going on tour, why I wanna see you on vacation? Why I wanna go to the same island you at? Why I wanna go to Miami while you're there? Why do I wanna go anywhere? I mean, and not that I don't love, but God damn.
365
nobody job like that, unless you work for the government.
Yeah, that's true. Hey, it's this lady that I've been in love with since I was 14. She's an artist and whatnot, and she would blow it all the way up. She still is. Let everybody know who the fuck she is now. Mm-hmm. And when I finally got her, I didn't feel like I was good enough for her because I'm a Jack Thriller, and my brand is crazy as hell, and her brand ain't like that. She like gospel singer and blah blah blah. Cookie cutter and stuff.
Yolanda.
Nah.
Michelle Williams.
Nah. I was trying to get Michelle. But you close. But yeah, I didn't think I was good enough and whatnot. And I remember when I had got married for real. I married a bitch that went nowhere near her level and all that shit. And you know, she didn't even lose respect for me. Yeah, you know, she was like, "Hey, when you get finished with that bullshit, I can still be over here, and you can come over here and kick, you know, to apologize and blah blah blah." But even when that was over, she, like, still making it hard for me because she on a whole nother level, and you know,
you liked it though, right? Because I like to have to work for it.
Make
me feel like I shit, so I can step up to the plate and show you I'm the motherfucking man.
I don't like the word that. I'm one of them niggas. I don't like the word that hard.
No,
but
why?
You
want
to work.
I don't want to work. No,
I don't want to work.
Scared.
No, I don't want to work.
But I don't want to be lover. Too easy, man.
What?
You got to give, she got to have some, she got to expect something from you. She got to expect something.
She already got kids. She already got kids, but I would like some more from her. I want some more out of her.
So you don't want her to expect nothing out of you, Jack?
So there's a chance you got another kid.
Yeah, we definitely, if we could ever get it back together. But
what I'm saying is, if you're going to do that, you're going to have a kid. Do you want to have a kid with somebody that's not strong and that don't make you feel like you gotta stand the fuck up?
I don't want that.
But listen, Pete, there's no area in your life where you can be better, that you know a woman can bring it out of you. Because I know if a woman bad enough and I got something lacking in me and she's making it seem like it's a problem, I'm gonna step up to the motherfucking plate like, I'm cool now,
but I wasn't cool then because I was just way too off the fucking chain. But off the chain was good for her that then.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is,
she loved it.
Because the shit is, just like for me, the shit that I do around the motherfuckers that's known me since I was in the fucking seventh grade and shit, or before. I was always like, oh, when I come here and do this shit, everybody looking at me, I'll be ready to punch somebody in the face.
Yep.
But what I realized was all the shit that I thought people would think was weird was the shit that made people fuck with me more.
Yeah,
it was like,
me too.
At the end of the day, it's not like, it's not necessarily the clothes or the hair or all the different shit that you do, like the accessory, whatever the fuck it is you wear, whatever the fuck it is that you do around that lifestyle, it's the fearlessness in it. You know what I'm saying? Like, everybody want to be the person that say, fuck it. Everybody want to be the person that can just articulate what it is that they feel in their feelings. And that shit take like a, it ain't natural. Like, that shit take a lot of hard work. But it's like, when you know who you are, and they ain't got nothing to do with nothing other than a person. Ain't nobody got to try to break that shit down into other shit. Just as a fucking person. When you're able to sit back and look at yourself in the mirror and be like, man, that's me. To the point where everybody that know you, or people that don't know, you just see, like, I don't know who that is, but that's him right
there. That's
him. Yeah. That's what you strive for, you know? Yeah. Walk comfortably in your skin, have your own thoughts, say the shit that you want to say, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Feel the shit that you want to feel. You know, like, it's easy to feel like you below somebody if you don't feel like you above yourself.
Yeah.
Oh, damn, nigga. That's how you gonna do me? That's how you gonna do me?
But that's real. That's what I'm looking for.
You know, I listen. I've been jacking up to this lady since I was 14.
Can we know her name, please?
And
you better tell me what's going on.
I grew up on
Jesus is king.
And Morris Cole or some shit.
I tell y'all can all know after.
Okay.
The show out.
But no, man. A woman. In closing with that, man, I just always want everything in my life. If I do, I wanted to step me up as a person and as a man. So with my job, with my friends, I don't got no friends around me that I can't look up to something and learn something from. And if I do, then I need to move on and find some new friends. And I want my woman to make me want to be a better man. So she gonna be looking at the stuff, because all the other women around me like, oh, you Robert Curry, da da da, and I'm amazing. And it's nothing for me to, it's no nothing for
me. Because you know how me too people is.
I'm stuck there. Yeah. But when your girl see the flaws in you and she loves you for that and make you step up for her, that's what I'm looking for. I want to be a better man because of my girl.
At the end of the day, my kids' mothers made me happy to become a man.
And there you go.
Straight up.
The right woman to make you happy.
And you know, it wasn't like
that. Sounds so easy.
It wasn't on no
it
easy.
The right
it
woman.
No, it's not easy, but it's
no
true.
Easy shit. It was on some like, nigga, what the fuck is wrong with you sometimes? And sometimes you gotta sit back and, you know, look, we're gonna preface it like, I've been famous for like a long time, and it's
96.
Like, a lot of people like, you don't get, so you kind of sitting there and it's like, I love you, but did you just tell me shut the fuck up and listen real quick? Because I was at a show, somebody said that, and that shit ain't go to you.
No, it didn't go to
it. And your brain can't, and your brain got tuned, you know, like, it take a while, but it's like, yo, when you grow up in this shit, and he tell you, you know, you've been, yo, this is some other shit to grow up in, and then go do what everybody else.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Not getting to be, it's like my friends running around doing teenage shit on reading contracts.
I ain't never had no teenage life. I ain't never had no teenage girlfriend. You know what I'm saying?
You a fucking grown ass woman
running my life.
Sucking your dick. You were 21. You
was, I'm just being honest. I'm just being honest. You grew up in this industry.
But nah, man, it's like when you grow up in this shit, it's some different shit.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And it's almost like you got to reintegrate yourself into life.
Real life.
You know what I'm
saying? I went to school looking down on my friends because they was talking about Jordans and Power Rangers and stuff like this, and I didn't get it. I had on Gucci loafers, and like I was doing contracts weeks before. I didn't get it when I went to school because I was homeschooled on
they
the road.
Like, fuck you, fake ass baby face.
And I didn't get it. I didn't get it. They in there with their Jordan sweatsuits on, and they like, what's this you been on? Like, I designed this. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I designed this.
Whoa!
Yo, that's real shit.
Whoa! All
right, just think about this. Let's just say you in, like, the 11th grade, right? And, like, for any fucking job you can have in the, for any job you can have in the world, let's say you making, like, a $500 a week stipend. That's, like, $2,000 a month. And you in high school, you sell drugs.
What?
Yeah.
You a dope dealer about to get killed.
So you acting the fuck. Man, no juice. Look, man, my shit was terrible. I was terrible. I'd be walking up to girls. I ain't even had no rap. I'd be like, you want me, don't you?
Oh,
that was your line. What's your name? What's your style?
Of course.
No, like, really?
I ain't never used
that.
What's
the normal response that I know? Like, yeah. What did they say? I want
to
know what they said.
They just walked.
I tell girls the truth all the time. I don't have no game. I never had to practice it. I don't really know it. Like, real
time. But I won't walk up to nobody.
I told my girl, like, I don't got no game.
If you make a certain amount of money, you couldn't even warn her.
I told her, I don't have no game.
It's like, listen, if somebody say this to you, say that to them back. I wouldn't say that
now.
But
see, that's what I was 14, you know, yeah, but I wouldn't say that now.
But the thing is, a lot of men, not even me, famous, think that they can walk up to women
and
like
they
that.
Would say and
the thing about that, I have to say to men, like, does that work? Right. Because the fact of the matter, they just come up to you acting like, oh, they that hot shit and all that. It's like,
I'm hot.
I want to know how many women this worked on.
Instagram been gave a lot of people their own fan base.
I want to know what works.
Listen, the internet gave a whole bunch of people their own fan base.
I'm telling
you, people rock their own reality. You got 100,000 followers on Instagram, you can get that from being in your own hood. But guess what? That make you a hood celebrity. So that make you feel like you can do those kind of things when you walk outside. It do. When you can go on your inbox and see bad girls on there, be like, yo, you know who I am. Let me see this. Let me see this. Let me see that.
Well,
if you can get it,
as being an artist, I could count on one hand how many times I've
or somebody has somebody was like a certain amount of followers with that blue check on the next
one. Right.
Like,
no,
a person can be like, hold on, wait, no, get up.
No,
I'm on Instagram.
Never wanted to, you know.
I got internet too.
Like, I've never really gone to when, you know, I was like, man, I'm Nokia from Jewel. Like, I don't even want nobody to know. For real, like, a person look me dead in my face and be like, anybody ever tell you you look like that guy from Jewel? I'm like, man, I don't fuck with the name. I don't listen to that shit.
And you know B-Way do it to me all the time. Nobody know where we at. Nobody know where
he
we
is. He is the king of that.
He be like, I'm over here with Robert Curry from Day 20. And I'm like, man, why are you doing it?
No, you know, and nobody ain't fucking. And nobody's fucking.
I mean, man, I feel like I done made it almost 30 years, man, and I can still, like, go out and do shit.
And be happy, man.
Like,
be
I ain't
cool.
Gonna go out nowhere where some shit, I don't give a fuck whether you're famous or not, but I'm just saying, like, just being able to go to the store, like, coming from a motherfucker basically making you feel like, you cannot go from your hotel room to the vending machine across the hall unless I come get you, walk you across the hall, and walk you back to your door, wait till
annoying.
You close the
Did
door
you
and sound like you said.
So annoying.
Now, after a while, you just like.
You start running from him. I'll be getting away from him. Debo done had to chase me a million times.
Go to another room.
It's not fun.
Debo done had to chase me a million times. Like, bro,
it's
I'm
not,
out.
It's not, you know, like.
It's not cool.
Because the thing is, it's the psyche part of it, where somebody is making you feel like
you a kid.
Happened to you.
Or like you a kid, or like
you know,
a kid to yourself.
Or somebody that's always reminding you, like my friend would always tell me, man, always be wary of people that's always reminding you what they do for you. So if you got a person that's sitting there like, man, I'm here to I'll take a bullet for you, man. I'm here to save your life. You said that
that's
when
right.
I hired you. You ain't
got
to tell
say it
me
again.
Every day.
Just please take the bullet if you don't mind. In the head this time, if you don't mind. Can you get killed for me? Please get murdered for me. If you don't mind.
One more time.
If you don't got shit to do tomorrow, can you please get killed?
Man, for real, at the end of the day, when it comes down to it, man, this business is like you constantly testing your mental and you constantly gotta build your mental. You know what I'm saying? And like the one thing that I say now, especially for as long as I've been in it, like when you get to the point where you're seeing the Matrix and you understand the stuff and you still here and people still selling out shows and everything else, and you got the knowledge, everybody say you're crazy.
Huh. Yeah, definitely.
Everybody say you crazy. What? Right now, it's like, you crazy because I can see what's going to happen already, and you going to go do it. Well, I'm crazy because, you know what, I feel like if I sat for 2 years to wait, but wait one more year, I could probably get something done. Because at this point, it's like, you know, what the fuck? Like, we here. Like, there's a lot of people that's not here. You know what I'm saying? Like, we get to do shows. We still get to connect with our fans. We ain't got to just talk to them, you know, on the internet and, you know, hope somebody, you know, FaceTime us or, you know, something like some of these, you know, like, dudes, like, when you're humble being in the club, trying to get it back, and you got your father's outfit, which is like the whole stress you want, man, and you got a t-shirt and a hat and a socks, and you just, you ain't got to do that. Like, you're just out here, it's a blessing, so you ain't got to do all that. Like,
doesn't the fans just make it all worth it, though?
Like, I mean, that's the, when you looking for, when you at that last grit on the side of the cliff and be like,
yeah,
man, I'm going
nobody
to
loves
the water. You know what I'm saying? Like, fuck it, I'm just splash and I'm just swing the way I fucking go. Like, they're the ones that, you know, like, and it goes beyond just that love because, like, you literally get a message from somebody.
Yeah.
Like, you know, I went through this or, you know, like, I was depressed and I was contemplating suicide or, you know, mm-hmm. it seemed like something going on and I just want to remind, you know, just like, you know, like, the first and the last thing people forget is, like, man, we human beings. Like,
yeah,
they don't turn us into robots when we get this shit. We're not Terminators and no shit like that. You know what I'm saying? It's like, we get tired, you know, we get hungry, they don't put no tired or hungry time on the schedule, only thing you on that work, and you gonna go do the work, and hope a nigga get some water, or I can get you a vending machine, and that's how it is when you starting out, for real.
But fans,
shit.
But fans are the key, like, they're the reason why my group is still alive today, like I said earlier, Diddy, the reason is not the reason why we still relevant, you know what I'm saying, the reason why we still relevant is because of the fans that we accumulated between that time and now that kept us working and that keep us on the stage and that keep us touring and that keep buying our projects when we put them out and everything like that. So, you know, the fans are definitely, they done kept me a mini world. Where I'm at, I am today is because of them. We got the best fans in the world. I always say that.
And then you put in the footwork too.
Yeah, I mean,
I mean, but that's footwork. I mean, like, I'm going out to see y'all cover times when y'all came to soundstage to perform. I mean, at the end of the day, when you're a performing artist, it's like you don't know what else to do. You know what I'm saying? It's like no matter what in the world is going on, you know, like five people you know could just die. You find like you got a baby on the way and you got $1 million check and it just be emotions everywhere.
All kind of emotions.
And then, ladies and gentlemen, you just got to go out there, motherfucker.
You
got to
act like none of that.
That's so just imagine.
That's
a
joint, really.
So just imagine. President
Dobby,
shit President for like then in 30 years. Like, you know? Like it just snaps on, like you don't even have to think about it. Like anything could be, I could be crying and sleepy and hungry at the same time, like a fucking baby.
But,
that's how you know you meant to do this, bro. Because you gotta be built for this. People can't do that. That's how you know you meant.
But you feel like it's worth it.
It is when you meant, when that's what you're made for. Of course,
you can't get. That's the thing. Like after being in it long enough, you know that like. Shit, like,
yeah, but everybody don't possess it either. So when you're able to maneuver and be able to do it, you know that's where you're supposed to be. Of course, it's worth it. Now, for somebody who's not in their lane, somebody who's doing something they not ain't got no business, they supposed to be somewhere else.
But see, that's why you find out.
Then you're gonna
shit
say, yeah, it's too much. It's
you
not
know
worth
what
I'm it.
Saying?
I'm losing more than I'm getting.
That's why you go write and you go produce and you go help artists. So like, you ain't gotta just stay in that space of like feeling like some motherfuckers stay on stage all 24/7.
Yeah,
like it's like. From whatever fuck it's like, that is what the fuck it is.
Yeah.
Look, it's, take that shit off like Superman, like that. You know what I'm saying? I ain't saving the world no more today.
Yep, and go live and go big.
When you out here and you trying to make it happen, like sometimes I feel like all of these different anxieties and different things going on within me, and I find myself complaining about everything that's like not right. But then at the same time, I say to myself, well, this is what you want.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so at the end of the day, if this is what you want, you can't complain. You got to go out there and you got to make
well,
this shit
I mean,
happen.
It's, you know what? It's like you can complain as a human, but still go do what the fuck you gotta do.
I tell
you,
yeah.
What I'm saying is, like,
you
gotta, like,
it
ain't no, you know what I'm saying?
It's gotta be for you.
If you wanna be a
you
complaining,
you complaining about it for you.
What I'm saying is, you let that emotion out because that shit is gonna turn into something else later.
Yeah, it's bad.
You don't complain to the people, but if you.
Don't ever let them in.
If the motherfuckers around you need to hear some motherfuckers a couple times for you to be able to go, they got it. That's what they're there for, to hear the motherfuckers. Right. Not for you to call them a motherfucker.
Right.
But, you know what I'm saying, for you to get your
Nokia
frustration.
Nokia, call me the motherfucker.
Right. You know what I'm saying? Like, you got to do that because that shit is going to come out some other time. You're going to come out some
maybe
other
money
conversation.
Would it come out.
You know what I'm saying? You let it go, but you never get. It's like when you go off stage and you doing that shit in front of the people, that's when it's like, somebody cut them off. I'm like,
yeah. And you know what? I say this all the time. I don't know. I hope I don't want to go too far because I'm kind of a spiritual.
No, go far.
I know I'm kind of a spiritual kind of guy.
We worship everything. We worship everything.
As entertainers, I say this all the time. Take my glasses off.
What you going to say?
Go ahead.
I say this all the time, man. We got a different kind of responsibility.
You got a pretty face.
and look, I really say it like as if people say all the time, like, man, like you say earlier, we not we not Terminators, da-da-da. But I do feel like we some kind of superheroes. Like, it take, first of all, and this is why I didn't want to go too far, but I'm going to go ahead and do it anyway. Feel me, feel me, we don't throw it back at it.
Let him use you, let him use you.
In heaven,
what they do in heaven?
God gave the devil the gift of music.
That's right.
He was the only person that could see God's face. The choir had to sing the praises to the devil, and the devil took them to God. They couldn't see him himself.
I'm an answer.
So then he cast them down here. What is his gift? You know what I'm saying? His gift is music. He's going to run this world with music. So for God to give me the same gift that he gave his most prized angel, his most best friend,
Lucifer.
Now I have to fight, and that lets me know that I have a job to do. You know what I'm saying? And that's why as artists, we can go. That's why as artists, we can do more. We can go further. We can do this and that. Because we have the power that God gave us only.
Here's it is. You don't want to become, you believe in that, and that's where you hold your heart. You don't want to become what he became.
Exactly.
And that's the fight.
His own.
Yeah, but the whole thing is, it's like, you know what? If you look at any movie, any sport, whatever, the only thing that anything can't affect is your free will. Mm-hmm. So everybody does it on their own.
Yeah, they do it on their own. But guess what? He gave you the same gift. What are you going
to
do with it?
He just presented to you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? There's a difference between the kid
that you come into
business that, you know, be drug free and I'm be clean and want to meet some girl with some coke on the titties, and then that's, you know, he drug at.
But just think about it. Drew Hill be like, we gonna all shave our heads bald today. So half of the men in America are gonna shave their heads bald because that's the influence. If Beyonce say, yo, wearing pink is the color of the month, they're gonna do it. That's the influence, just like the devil had over the whole world. We got this, music is what he used for that influence. And that we have that gift is for a reason. It's obviously we the army that's opposing, you know what I'm saying? That we have to use it, the same thing. So I do look at us like superheroes.
That's why things that we can't do that most average people do. Like a person that, like, it'll be a song, and it's just like, yo, you know what? Like, nah, yo, things ain't right on that joint, yo.
Hey, with that being said,
you touch that.
With that being said, Prince said to Drew Hill, oh, you guys have the dragon.
Oh, my God. What?
I got a funny story.
What was that? Yo, what's that? Give that man some water, somebody. I'm killing folks on TV. Give that man some water.
I'm going to let him tell
you. You love Prince, man. So.
Yeah, yeah. I know you love Prince.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Yo, so, darling Nikki.
Oh, yeah. She didn't get to see me do Pop Life, man.
Oh, Nikki, Pop Life was my favorite shit.
Yeah,
I love. Hey, play Pop Life when we taking our pictures.
Yeah, you
got it. Look up Pop Life right now. Hey, make sure that shit be on deck when we take our pictures.
Man, like, so he had invited, we were out in LA, and he invited us to the show at the Hollywood Bowl, right? So we go to the show and it's like, we out there going for it, and it's like, this year, this like 97 or so, like, shit. So we had the show.
Next
so
year.
Then it was like, we end up going to, I guess it was still Billboard Live or Billboard Club on Sunset, and he was having his after party. So I'm always wandering off and shit. So I wander off, I walk upstairs, I go to the second floor, and I look up, and he just standing there and shit. And he had lollipop and shit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, like, Prince had a lollipop.
You know you love that lollipop.
So, like, he just standing there, I'm looking at him, and he looking at me, and he like, you gonna say something, nigga, or what?
He really said something. I heard he was gangster to the motherfucker.
What did you say?
I heard he always been gangster to the motherfucker.
I was like, man, ever seen this? Ever said this?
That's what you say?
So I was like, man, ever since I saw Purple Rain, man, my life changed, man. Like, that was it for me, like, because it was just the understanding. I was in the rock first. Like, I was like 80s headband, Poison, you know, like all of that shit. So it was like to see a black man, you know what I'm saying, like with the James Brown and the Jimi Hendrix, we still had that rock, and like you knew he was a nigga.
Mm-hmm. You still, well, you talk to him, right?
But he did what he wanted to do, and that's the whole thing, man. Like, my man did what he wanted to do his whole life. Like, that's the greatest gift we could be given as artists, to have your art be taken in on the highest level possible for the longest amount of time. And you just do, that's why you gotta just be who the fuck you are, man. Like, this is some shit that don't happen. It ain't, oh, every once in a while. This shit don't happen.
That's why he's the man he is.
So it's like, why are you in this motherfucker? Do what the fuck you want to do.
Yeah.
do all the shits that's on your mind, all the, you know, as long as you ain't hurting nobody, you ain't fucking nothing up, do whatever it is your heart desire, because you might not get the opportunity.
I love that right there. Yeah, I love it.
You're a princess.
And you only got so much time to do it.
I heard it.
That's a word.
I like
it. Hey, man, hey, let's go ahead and wrap it up and tell everybody what we got going on real quick, man. Let's start with Chris. Let's do it. 420.
Man, Chris Christopher, my artist name, 420Chris925. I got an album dropping Friday the 15th, THC number 3. I done put out 2 others in the past. We have Burner on there, Be Legit, many others, and all produced by Rob Lowe. We did everything from Jack and Mac Drake to represent his Bay Area culture. We got Smoke Vibe. Check it out on Friday, 420Chris925.
Pow! How do you feel about the show today, man? As the newbie on the show today, we always have a newbie.
My first time. This is dope. Even really in this type of like environment. So this is dope show, dope content. Some great artists on the
insight.
Show and yeah, insight. Exactly. Actually, even the it's real life though. Even down to the relationship stuff. Like I'm just we all go through.
You about to break up with your girl tomorrow?
Can Daddy get another drink?
As an artist on the relationship segment, it's one of the hardest things. So man, y'all dope, y'all inspiration. You know what I mean? That's tight.
Love, I'm gonna need some of them tits, so we gonna have to exchange.
Yeah,
you want some tits?
Give my man some tits. A lot of dope strains. Representing the Bay Area, where the cookies and everything started from. That we changed the world with the strain game, man. Salute to the weed that bring us all together. So that's
love, bro. That's right. That's the only thing I don't like about weed, though. It just put niggas together that wouldn't normally fuck with.
It do.
What's wrong with that?
I don't. But for that moment, while we all together, we all on the same.
No,
but
exactly.
We all on the
same.
Yeah.
That's why the government tried to make it illegal. They don't want us congregating.
Right.
We ain't gonna go there.
Too many black people
I definitely don't want these two niggas right here together. I want them to sit. Right, y'all never sitting by each other no more. Ever.
Listen, we all gonna come together as one.
No.
Amen.
Yeah, no.
You're making her stupid.
Get cured.
You're making her stupid. Yo, yeah.
The energy is transferable.
Man, definitely day 26. We got the TB tour going on right now. Us, Ray J, B5. Us, Ray J, B5, and Immature. So it's TV.
Yo, I love Immature. I'm gonna tell you something. Yo, Marcus Houston, the reason why my hair ain't here no more.
You told me that. I try
to get my shit like when he had a slick back with the little ponytail right here.
Why?
Right,
why?
With the puff right here. Yeah, the perms don't do well in my hair.
Clearly.
Yeah, amen. I was doing it ever since like 12th grade. And I had my shit like Marcus Houston all the way up to the 9th grade. Yeah, Marcus Houston fucked my life up, Batman.
Oh, man.
We the same age. I'm up here looking up to a nigga. We the same age.
There's a lot of artists in this game I feel like that about. So
yeah,
I can't start over. How many grown men look
this
for baby
Michael? This is my look. This is my look. And niggas already know I'm bald head. Like I can't come back with a box tomorrow.
Hey,
like
it's your lace.
You can if you want to. Didn't he just finish telling you you got the platform. Do what you want to do. He would have came the next day with a box if he wanted it. Go up in the box, then it burned.
Just
a third pistol.
If that's how you feel, man. Just don't just don't come back with like none of these.
Oh, and I'm gonna make fun of you too, but I'm just saying, still. Be your thug good.
Live the way you wanna live.
I'm gonna
deal with what happened when you live the way
just
you wanna live.
Live the way you wanna live, just deal with the consequences.
Yo, niggas know I'm not legit.
It's your man. You get a mix strip.
Hey, this is my man Art right here. This is my man Art. Like Art got the full beard. It ain't Beijing. It look Beijing, but it's not. It's all natural. His hairline, yo, that shit had never happened to me. Every time I look at a nigga, it make me mad. I'm proud of him.
Yo, come on, man. It's gotta be something. Like when you're on the plane, they got them things like the red light beams that go into your head.
That's what pissed me off about you too. I ain't on the front. You just do what the fuck you want to do. It don't matter if it don't go with your face or not. You will do whatever. And God just bless you to be able
to do it.
Just to do it. He could just fuck off. He braids one day. He'll have some shit. He'll have one braid coming out of like a perm shit going out this way.
A rhino horn.
I can't do it.
The man butt.
I told you in the beginning.
I love everything he do, bro. I love everything he do because I can't do it.
Yo, you know what it was, man?
You love everything he do because it's original.
And I went to the store with my mama, and she went and got a box of dark and lovely honey blonde hair. So we get home, and she did shit, and I was like, oh, that's dope. And she was like, you want to try it now? I was a big fan of Kwame. So I was like,
Kwame.
You mean I could dye my hair?
Polka dot Kwame?
You mean I could dye my hair? And I'm in the 7th grade. And the next day, she let me do it, and it's been a wrap.
It's been a wrap ever since.
So over there, she let you be you.
And you got a good grade of hair. That's why you got to be like careful, fellas.
Just drink. Don't be letting them girls perm your hair.
No. Don't be nothing in them girls. To find out who their granddaddy is.
You stupid.
Find out who their daddy is, and if they shit fucked up, if them niggas is crazy, don't you nut in them motherfuckers. And ladies, same thing. If a motherfucker daddy look crazy and shit, it don't matter how much you love that nigga, man. Don't do that shit. That's if you want to do that. Don't be treating them people like fantasy people.
Fantasy people.
Don't treat nobody like no fantasy.
Nah.
I'm not your fetish. Don't treat me like no fetish.
Hey, man.
Don't treat me like no fetish. If you want to be with me, be with me. If you want somebody to look like me, be with me.
Okay, listen.
We had a great episode of Party and Bullshit today. Anything that I said that was offensive, I meant that shit, and you can kiss my motherfucking ass. Yeah. Bitch ass nigga! Party and Bullshit, we over and out, and we taking pictures, man. Yeah. Yo, press play, let's go! Yeah.